Hey, did you know that Mexico is electing all new leaders from the president to local elections in like 2 weeks? I certainly didn't, because it's getting about as much coverage as Melania Trump's anti-cyberbullying campaign. Which, yeah, that's still a thing. I'm starting to think she was less missing for 20 days and more hosting a rally that had a lower attendance rate than my high school art class at 420. Unfortunately, and yes, I appreciate the hypocrisy, we're going to continue that trend of not covering it. Because the Mexican elections are 2 weeks away, and we need to know which progressive leader Donald Trump's going to be breaking all the rules of his wife's anti-bullying campaign to shit all over on Twitter. Due to the term limits, we will, for sure, see a new president in Mexico next month. Now, there are a few interesting things about these elections. First, let's talk about the candidates. Now, I hate to use the term foregone conclusion, but yeah, it kinda is. Congratulations, Obrador! You're more popular than the one guy who brings actual food to a barbecue. So, what do you stand for? Well, he is running a vicious campaign against the biggest competitor to him. Now, you don't need to know much Spanish to understand this reporter's quoting of candidate Obrador.
Donald Trump is similar to Adolf Hitler.
I've heard our president get compared to Hitler quite a few times, but I gotta tell you, somehow it sounds a lot more pleasant in Spanish. He might mention the Mexican border wall in his campaign more times than Donald Trump did, saying that he's going to go to the UN if Trump actually ever ends up building the thing. Alright. So clearly, the probably president-elect of Mexico is not going to be buddy-buddy with Donald Trump. Didn't see that one coming. Now, despite the fact that clearly, by virtue of the fact that Trump is Trump and seems to somehow be relevant to every major news story around the globe, to think of this election as being based on US politics would be like hearing the song You're So Vain and thinking it's actually about you. In reality, Obrador is
Manuel López Obrador. He is the Bernie Sanders of Mexican politics. He's a far-left populist who promises to make Mexico more equitable for the poor, overhaul public health, offer free university education, break up monopolies, delay NAFTA, and use the United Nations to stop President Trump's proposed border wall, which he claims is not necessary.
All right, quick side note before I continue. I usually give Fox News a hard time for being about as fair and balanced as a commenter on 4chan, but if you can avoid Tucker Carlson, they really did a pretty good job covering this election compared to MSNBC, who ran one video about their favorite topic, Russian election interference, but this time in Mexico. Anyways, back to the story, because I mean Obrador is being called the Mexican Bernie Sanders. That's quite the claim. I can already hear liberals chanting, "Ooh, the Bernie Sanders of Mexico, I'm moving down there." But before you do, let's not try to judge someone based on their economics. Because, and I don't know an easy way to tell you guys this, but recently, Obrador entered into a coalition with the Social Encounter Party, a tiny party with religious roots that pushes an anti-gay, anti-abortion agenda. It turns out that, and I did extensive research to confirm this, apparently you can be fiscally liberal while being socially conservative. I know, crazy! This left gay rights activist Lolkin Castañeda saying, "It looks like our rights will have to keep waiting." Alright, so he's not a liberal's waking dream incarnate, but religion informs some of his politics. One of his major platforms is corruption. A promise by Andrés Manuel López Obrador to tackle rampant corruption has helped propel him to front-runner status. Alright, now I know to drain the swamp was a thing in Trump's campaign, but in Mexico, it's more like drain the ocean. If you thought the US was run by the Koch brothers, then Mexico is run by the Koch brothers. They're having a legitimate problem with candidates this year because so far in this election cycle, 113 candidates have been murdered, including 43 running for actual office. Which, okay, yeah, that's not great. I mean, that's a lot of dead politicians, to the point that, come voting day, you should check the obituaries to make sure you're not wasting your vote. Clearly, this is not good, especially when the best way of verifying that your representative isn't corrupt is finding them dead. This leads to another controversial stance of Obrador's, because he floated the idea of an amnesty for drug cartel kingpins, saying he wanted a dialogue on the drug war that has cost the country an estimated 200,000 lives of the last decade. Now, as you can guess, this has been problematic for some, as, in Mexico, the war against drugs is more of a literal war, with soldiers being sent into the southern regions in order to fight the drug cartels. And this is viewed by some to be essentially surrendering to a literal criminal enterprise. Although, it could potentially stop the fighting. Now, this isn't the first time government groups in Mexico have signed pacts with cartels, but critics point out that these drug enterprises have become less centralized. So, even if you wanted to negotiate, there aren't kingpins in the same way there used to be. In the one time, I guess you could hope that drug lords would have good organizational structures. So, alright, that's probably not the corruption that Obrador is against. What corruption are we talking about? Just, you know, general corruption? Or something even worse than drug lords? Businessmen. López Obrador says the efforts against him are part of a dirty war waged by wealthy tycoons who want to stop him and who have enriched themselves at the expense of ordinary Mexicans, 40% of whom live below the poverty line. Alright, now I would normally take this with a grain of salt, but rich people are spending a suspicious amount of money to campaign against him. Although, in Mexico, wealth inequality is pretty extreme. Oxfam found that the four richest Mexicans are worth as much as the nation's 20 million poorest people. Which, okay, yeah, they can easily afford all the attack ads that they're taking out against him. So what are they attacking him about? I mean, he's a socialist who wants to drastically increase the size of government programs, proposed amnesty for drug dealers, and is somewhat against progressives on issues of morality. This can't be too hard, you guys. They're going with the old tried and true Hugo Chavez comparison. Because if there's any socialist leader who's bad at his job, it's him. Since he has been the frontrunner in the Mexican race, the peso has tumbled against the dollar, and the markets seem to be worried. Although, should they be? Because objects in campaign mode are not as left as they appear.
AMLO has surrounded himself with very capable technocrats in his administration, or in his kind of, you know, close cohort of people that are delivering a very market-friendly, positive message to the markets. I think if it's not broken, don't fix it. And AMLO is faced with an economy that's, yes, growing very slowly, but understands that NAFTA is important for Mexico, that maintaining trade relations are important, and that nationalizing private enterprise is not the way that you can make an economy continue to grow.
Ooh, as a guy who studied economics, I love to hear the word technocratic. Because, unlike politicians, these people, at least in theory, know what the heck they're talking about when it comes to the economy. Oddly enough, these are the exact people who would probably advise Obrador to help the same people he's saying he's at war with. Also, fortunately enough, unlike our current president whose previous participation in politics can be summed up with zero words, this leader used to be the mayor of Mexico City, so we can see exactly how radical his politics are. Turns out, if this guy's a radical socialist, then I'm Stalin, because some of his many achievements were giving New York's former mayor and current embarrassment Rudy Giuliani a $4.3 million contract to consult for the government and police force of Mexico City and draft up a zero-tolerance law for crimes. Well, if you say so, teleprompter. He gave large tax breaks to construction firms in order to encourage large private investment in new developments, and created social programs to help the vulnerable in Mexico City. Now I know some of you are saying, aha, that last one is socialism, but I might classify that more under the category of not being an asshole. It, for the most part, wasn't that radical. What people suspect will happen when he gets into office, and stop me if this sounds familiar, but to quote the New York Times, judging by his track record as the mayor of Mexico City, it seems likely as president he would maintain a shrewd, responsible fiscal policy to fight corruption and expand social policies. But it also seems likely that if he secures absolute power, he would mobilize his ground troops to fight his enemies, divide the world into good guys and bad guys, and use strategies such as popular referendums to avert legal obstacles. Well, those negatives sound pretty familiar to someone I know, but I'm sure he's got a much better temperament. And he just threatened Donald Trump with the Twitter war. Aren't modern politics just so much fun? Maybe the best president for this era is a high school girl. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, if you want to support nonpartisan comedic reporting, please subscribe to my channel and like below. As always, thank you for watching.